I've always felt that the bigger the audience and the more involved the audience can be, which is very difficult when it gets that big, the more powerful the performers are on stage. They get the energy from the audience just as much as the audience gets the energy from the performer. So I felt that when Mick used to give them that bow, that he was thanking them for giving them that energy. And it's a moment that I consider, you know, to be one of the better moments in rock and roll. Lynn, are you ready?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Ah, very nice.
And I hope like a lot of people still come out because it's raining.
They'll come out.
Fortunate enough to be in the lobby of the Deauville Hotel in Miami Beach before they walked on the Ed Sullivan Show. I was unlucky in that at that period of time I had committed myself as a young teenager to the Rolling Stones and really didn't care for the Beatles, so I refused to photograph their faces. Because I saw those boots and they reminded me of James Brown, who I had seen perform in Detroit, and he wore boots like that, so I knew underneath it all, the Beatles had to be really cool. Rock and roll is a mindset. Miles epitomized that mindset. You know, he broke rules. The session didn't start off that well. He basically tortured me for many hours until I threatened him that I would photograph his twin brother instead. That was when he said to his son, "Get me my horn." To me, Miles Davis is, you know, the roots of rock and roll. I want to really thank everyone who showed up to me. So many friends that I haven't seen for a very, very long time.
Right through the city tonight. We'll see the city's ripped back sides. We'll see the bright and hollow sky. We'll see the stars that shine so bright. A stars made for us.